Hello everyone, welcome to our YouTube channel Education Information. Here we will discuss all the important questions from the topic Niti Aayog. So this topic is very important for the BPSC, UPSC, JPSC or any other state PSC level exams which has been coming in the year 2021. So here we will discuss all the important questions. The total number of questions is here 30 and the topic is Niti Aayog. So one or two questions asked in every examination, so it is a very important topic. So without any delay, we have to start here. The first question is, who is the chairman of Niti Aayog? The first question is, who is the chairman of Niti Aayog? So the correct option is Prime Minister. So current Prime Minister of India is Narendra Modi is the chairman of Niti Aayog. Option C is the correct option. So move to the next question. Who is the current vice chairman of Niti Aayog? As in April 2018. So the correct option is option A, Rajiv Kumar. Rajiv Kumar is the current vice chairman of Niti Aayog. Next question is, who is the current CEO of Niti Aayog? So Amitabh Kant. So currently Amitabh Kant, option C. Amitabh Kant is the current CEO of the Niti Aayog. Option C is the correct option. For next question is, what does T stands in Niti Aayog? What does T stands in Niti Aayog? The correct option is option E, transforming. T stands for here, transforming. Niti Aayog, this T, the question has been asked T. So this T means transforming. Next question is, which is not one of the seven pillars of effective governance in we says by Niti Aayog? Which is not one of the seven pillars of effective governments advised by Niti Aayog? So the correct option is efficiency. So this and these four all are the pillars of effective governments. Effective governments by Niti Aayog. So the correct option is option B. Efficiency is not one of the seven pillars among these all fives. So next question is, which is not one of the seven pillars of effective governments envisaged by Niti Aayog? So the correct option is option D, women empowerment. Women empowerment is not one of the seven pillars of effective governments envisaged by Niti Aayog. Next question is, the first meeting of newly constituted Niti Aayog forum for Northeast was held in which of the following cities? So Agartala is the correct answer. So this meeting was held in the Agartala in 2018. So correct option is option C, Agartala. Next question is, the prime focus of development projects in the eight northeastern states will be based on the concept of HIRA. What does R denote in this concept? So here HIRA, the question has been asked for R. The year R stands for railways. Option D. D is the correct option. Option D. Next question is, who among the following persons from Niti Aayog has co-chaired the Niti Forum for the Northeast? So the question has been asked, who among the following persons from the Niti Aayog has co-chaired of the Niti Forum? So correct option is vice chairman. So current vice chairman, who is the vice chairman? Rajiv Kumar is the vice chairman of Niti Aayog. So option B is the correct option. Next question is, Atal Innovation Mission flagship program of think tank. So this is very important topic and very important questions for all the upcoming exams. So this question has been already asked in the UPSC 2015. The 2019. Next question is, Atal Innovation Mission flagship program of think tank Niti Aayog has recently signed a statement of intent which of the following organization to promote culture of innovation and entrepreneurship across 100 Atal Thinking Labs in the country. So the current option is SAP. SAP was one of the participant of this 100 Atal Thinking Labs in the country. Infosys, TCS, Tech Mahindra, Wipro, these are not the participants. So next question is, Niti Aayog has recently signed a statement of intent which of the following organizations for supporting transformations of healthcare, education and nutrition in aspirational districts of the country. health care, education and nutrition in expense of the country. The correct option is option E, Piramal Foundation. Piramal Foundation is the correct option, which has been supporting organization for transforming of healthcare, education and nutrition expense districts of our the country. Next question is, total number of aspirants, aspirational districts has been selected in the country under aspirational districts scheme by Niti Aayog. So total number of district is 115 districts has been selected in the country under aspirational districts schemes by Niti Aayog. Next question is, which of the following is a comprehensive project released by Niti Aayog for introducing system wide governance transformation in school education. The correct option is Sathi program. This program has been related to the governance of transforming in the school education system. So correct option is option C, Sathi program. Next question is, women entrepreneurship platform has been launched by which of the following organizations on March 8, 2018 to commemorate International Women's Day. So who has been launched, the question has been asked, who has been launched? So the correct option is Niti Aayog has been launched following on March 2018 to commemorate International Women's Day. Next question is, which of the following is not one of the participating states of the flagship Sathi program by Niti Aayog? Which of the following is not one of the participating states? So Telangana and Maharashtra were not participating states of flagship Sathi program by Niti Aayog. These two states are the participant of this program. So correct option is option E, both A and B. Next question is, which of the following is not one of the pillars structured by Niti Aayog on which of the Women Internship Forum will sustain? Swachh Shakti, this is not one of the pillar structured by Niti Aayog. Karm Shakti, Ichha Shakti, Gyan Shakti, and all of the above options are pillar by Niti Aayog. So these all options are the presently pillar structured by Niti Aayog, but Swachh Shakti is not one of the pillars structured by Niti Aayog. Next question is, Niti Aayog has recently recommended setting up which of the following government bodies for better servicing of loans, which will lead to substantial reductions in India's interest payment. The correct option is option D, Independent Debt Management Office. The correct option is option D. Next question is, who among the following has become the first Indian and the member of Niti Aayog to receive the prestigious Ihsan Dogra Massey Family Health Foundation Prize by WHO? The correct option is option C, Vinod Pal. Vinod Pal is the first Indian and the member of Niti Aayog to receive the prestigious Ihsan. Whichever? Ihsan Dogra Massey Family Health Foundation Prize. The correct option is option D. Next question is, which of the following is the higher education scheme launched by Ministry of HRD for associating renowned scientists, entrepreneurs across the globe with the institutes of higher education in India? The correct option is option E, GIAN. Gyan is the scheme launched by Ministry of HRD for associating renowned scientists, entrepreneurs across the globe with the institutes of higher education in India. Next question is, Niti Aayog is planning to set up a methanol economy fund with an initiative outlay of approximately how much amount for promoting production and use of clean fuel in the country? How much amount? The question has been asked, how much amount? So the correct option is option B, INR 5000 crore rupees. Next question is, Government of India has constituted a committee headed by which of the following persons for addressing of NPAs in India's power sector? So Amitabh Kant, this is the CEO of the Niti Aayog. Amitabh Kant has been headed by the addressing the of NPAs Indian power sector. Next question is, Who has inaugurated the first Indian Japan workshop? The question has been asked, first India Japan workshop on disaster risk reduction in March 2018. So correct option is VC, the VC of Niti Aayog, Vice Chairman of Niti Aayog, Rajiv Kumar. Next question is, which of the following districts has topped the first list of aspirational district program released by Niti Aayog in March 2018? The correct option is option D, Vizianagaram. Vizianagaram is the first list of aspirational district program released by Niti Aayog in March 2018. Next question is, Niti Aayog has released Healthy State Progressive India report. Which of the following states has topped the list of best overall performance state among the small state category? Kerala, Punjab, Tamil Nadu have emerged as the best performing states among the large states category. The correct option is option D, Mizoram. Mizoram is the correct option. Next question is, who is the current World Bank India Country director who released the report Healthy States Progressive India report jointly with CEO Amitabh Kant of Niti Aayog? The correct option is Junaid Ahmed. Junaid Ahmed was with the Amitabh Kant in the release, at the time of release of the report, Healthy State Progressive India report. Next question is, who among the following has been recently appointed as the first director of Ayushman Bharat Mission, a flagship program of the Government of India for providing affordable health facilities for poor in India? The correct option is option A, Dinesh Arora. Next question is, Government of India has constituted a committee headed by which of the following person for studying the Brahmaputra and flood control measures in Assam and nearby states? So the correct option is here, Rajiv Kumar. Who is Rajiv Kumar? The Vice Chairman of Niti Aayog. Rajiv Kumar has constituted a committee headed by Rajiv Kumar for studying the Brahmaputra and the flood control measures in Assam and nearby states. Next question is, Niti Aayog has signed a MOU with which of the following state governments for creating an online dashboard of 115 most backward districts of India? The correct option is Andhra Pradesh. So the government of Andhra Pradesh and the Niti Aayog government has been creating an online dashboard, signed a MO for creating an online dashboard for the 115 most backward districts of India. The correct option is option C. Next question is, who has inaugurated the Niti Aayog's first global initiative on academic network course and sustainable urban planning at IIT Kanpur Outreach Center in Noida recently? The correct option is R. Ratan P. Vatal, Principal Advisor to Niti Aayog, has launched the Niti Aayog's first global initiative on academic network course on sustainable urban planning at IIT's Kanpur Outreach Center in Noida recently. So the next and last question is, Vice Chairman of Niti Aayog, Rajiv Kumar, has recommended setting up which of the following funds for addressing the issue of growing redundancy of low skilled labor in India with the advent of automation in the country? So correct option is option E, labor utilization fund. That is, you can say in the short, LUF. You can say LUF, that is labor utilization fund. So these are the all important 30 questions, and you should have remember all the 30 questions. These are very important questions, and the PDF has been given in the description box. So you can go through the link and download the PDF of this, all the 30 questions. So all of you guys, thank you for watching these 30 important questions. So I hope these all important questions will be helpful for your upcoming PCS level exams in 2021. Thank you, everyone.